Your body is home to trillions of bacteria and other tiny organisms that can only be seen with a microscope. The vast universe of these organisms, or microbes, living in and on your body is known as the human microbiome. We now understand that the microbiome, and particularly the microbes in the gut, where most of them live, play a key role in nearly every aspect of our health and well-being, especially during childhood. Beginning at birth, microbes in the gut perform important duties, such as helping us to break down and absorb food, protecting the gut from harmful organisms, and helping to train a child's developing immune system to defend the body from infections and illnesses. The CHILD Cohort Study is a unique Canadian research project that has been studying the microbiome and the health and development of nearly 3,500 children across the country from pregnancy to school age and beyond. By following these children and their families over many years, CHILD has made exciting discoveries about how the types and balance of certain bacteria can shape health, and how changes to the microbiome may partly explain the shifting rates of childhood asthma, allergies, obesity, and other chronic diseases. Among other studies, CHILD research has found that the way a baby is born can have an effect on the gut microbiome. Babies born by cesarean section have a different microbiome compared to babies who are born vaginally and exposed to microbes from mom in the birth canal. Babies of mothers who received antibiotics during labor are also more likely to have changes in their gut microbiome. While antibiotics kill harmful microbes that cause infection, they can wipe out good ones too, which may lead to babies having a higher risk of childhood allergies and other conditions down the road. CHILD was one of the first studies to identify specific microbes that may influence asthma. By looking at the gut bacteria of babies in the study, CHILD researchers found that infants at a high risk of asthma had low levels of four gut bacteria in their first 3 months of life. The bacteria are called Faecalibacterium, Lacnospira, Veillonella, and Rothia, tongue-twisting names that have been nicknamed FLVR, or flavor, for short. It's not yet clear why some infants have low levels of flavor bacteria early in life, but finding out could help researchers predict which children are at risk for asthma and perhaps even prevent asthma from developing in the first place. CHILD research has also found that what a baby eats affects its gut microbiome. Breastmilk is a very specialized food for babies and their gut bacteria. Breastfed babies have higher proportions of specific healthy bacteria and lower proportions of bacteria associated with obesity and other disorders, which means that breastfeeding may influence a baby's microbiome and help protect against obesity in early childhood. Factors in the home environment, such as the frequent use of cleaning products or the presence of a furry pet, may also affect a baby's microbiome. CHILD researchers have found that infants living in households where disinfectants such as multi-surface cleaners were used at least weekly were 2 times as likely to have an altered microbiome, and this was associated with children being overweight at 3 years of age. On the other hand, having a pet might influence the microbiome in a positive way. CHILD found that babies from families with furry pets, especially dogs, tended to have higher levels of 2 specific types of bacteria, and this was associated with lower rates of childhood allergies and obesity. All of these findings from the CHILD Cohort Study are helping parents, health professionals, caregivers, and communities understand what makes up a healthy baby's gut. And in the future, this will help all of us make more informed decisions about how to build a strong and healthy microbiome in early life, with the goal of reducing the risk of health problems later on.